And
we've
heard
that learning doesn't take place only in classrooms, either in primary school, secondary school, or higher education. So learning takes place everywhere, either under the bridge, outdoors, through the Zoom, or even in a during a show in a circus. And Matthias Kurt from the Sloga platform will tell us more about a circus and climate change. Why have you chosen such an approach, which is slightly strange? So thank you for the opportunity to talk about the Climate of Change project. And I'll focus on this circus as an example of an interesting practice on raising awareness. It's a strange combination, but it makes a sense. So now something about Climate of Change. It is funded by the European Commission under the DEAR program. It's the Education and Raising Awareness on Development, and also the Ministry of External Affairs is involved here. There are 16 partners from 13 countries, and our aim is to raise awareness among Europeans and their critical understanding of migrations caused by climate change. So it is focused on climate change as a cause, then climate justice, and some other issues. We also try to activate the people, and it is divided into four pillars. The first are reports and publications on which the messages of the campaign are based. At the end of December, we expect the report from the fields and the description of the situation in countries such as Guatemala, Senegal, Cambodia, and Kenya. So Kenya instead of Ethiopia, because the researchers couldn't go to Ethiopia. So how the researchers understand the climate change and the migration. We have also issued a report on the economy of welfare as our response to the current economy leading to a disaster and climate change, also a climate guide, which is available in English. In 1 month, it will also be available in Slovenian. We also developed some other materials, and all this has been integrated into the education and raising awareness through discussions, through workshops, and so these are the activities on global learning, including debates, as a specific skill that the participants acquire. And these activities take place in secondary schools and for the age group from 19 to 25. And anybody interested in that can contact us. We also organize other events, the workshops for young instructors and decision makers. Our external communication is integrated into the pan-European campaign started in April this year, both online and live. So we take part at festivals next year at the European level. We'll organize workshops, and in Slovenia We will invite to Slovenia the speakers from Bologna. We wish that they share their experience. And this circus performance is an example of innovative praxis, but before that I would quickly like to talk about the results of the survey carried out by Ipsos in the EU member states. 20,000 young people were involved to see how young Europeans understand the relationship between climate change and migration. And here you can see the data on Slovenia, and we can see that youth are very much concerned about the consequences of climate change, and what they mentioned is environmental degradation, poverty, and famine. So the young are informed on these issues via TV, social networks, and informative web pages. So they don't mention schools at such a top rank. So this survey shows that understanding the climate change issues and migration is not at the level we would wish, and that the information is not obtained primarily through the education system. So we can see that there is a need to increase the knowledge and to raise awareness, and the formal education system should contribute today to that, and informal learning also plays a key role, and all other forms of education. And this climate of change project focused mainly on the youth. We shouldn't forget the importance of a comprehensive approach, a global component. We need to make sure that the education is transformative, inclusive, and that both young and adults are included. So it is transformative, and actually connects different generations. So this performance is performed by Magda Klan Circo and Circus School Flick Skola. So there are eight countries involved. It will take place 5 months, and it will end in a month. So the circus, the tour stopped in Slovenia, in Nova Gorica, at the beginning of August, and that was part of their project of the European Capital of Culture. Also, the accompanying program has been organized, taking place mostly outdoors, on the streets, and our partner at the local level was involved. So I would also like to talk about a workshop, making graffitis using the moss, so that it is successful on the wall. We not only acquired new skills, we also can produce a work of art locally. In our case, unfortunately, we weren't very successful because of the heat wave in Nova Gorica, 38 degrees Celsius, so the moss couldn't grow. But this is another story then. change the hairstyle, change your mindset. That it took place 2 days in the morning and in the afternoon, and the actually people could get a free of charge haircut and understand the social consequences of climate change. We used sound stories explaining what is going on and why, and also there was a discussion on what we can do, but the central point was the contemporary circus performance on two evenings about climate change and of all its consequences, the floods, melting of thermal frost and other stories. What we wish is to include the wider public into the story, showing them that our actions have an impact on the entire world. More than 1,700 people saw that performance, and we were also there with stands to inform people. The interest was high all the time, and also this performance was also interesting for the media. The reactions of people were very positive, and the structure of the viewers was different, young and old, local people also from Italy, because it's on the border with Italy. So this approach, this program, this performance is actually at the crossroads between art and a fight for the environment. And through this, so we come across this approach more and more frequently. We heard earlier about the performance by the Mladinsko Theater, so social issues, arts, and this approach is innovative because from the transfer of data and information regarded by many as not interesting to a change in mindset. So through awareness raising new experience, individuals are actually guided to thinking about what we can do as active citizens. After six performances, we actually obtained a sample to analyze how successful such an approach is, and also we obtained the feedback from all our partners and the visitors' reaction. So the feedback shows that most of the visitors liked the performance, and also the majority of the visitors replied that the performers didn't actually reach the target of raising awareness. It is logical because such a performance can't deal in more detail all the issues. So we'll try to get more feedback, and this is what we are currently doing. And all the partners actually realized that the visitors were both young and old, and that the adult visitors actually expressed a lot of interest, and they talked about the content, that is, the consequences of climate change. And this external communication plays here a crucial role. Actually, we need to put emphasis on this awareness-raising component of the performance. This is perhaps not the best type of art, so, but this communication in advance is crucial. So what we do also through such a performance is to channel these issues to the wider public. So here we have the climate of change vision, which is integrated into the whole campaign and the petition that was launched in Nova Gorica together with the performers to call on the European Union to develop policies to achieve the climate neutrality by 2030, that to move away from the existing economy to the economy which is environmentally friendly, that we actually provide support to countries affected by climate change and also migration, and that the young are actually involved and engaged, and they take part in decision making. It is important that our voice is heard, and to conclude, we don't want the content of the performance and the performance only for the visitors that could see it. So all the partners are now developing video reports and other deliverables, and in November, when it ends its way in Brussels, it will be available to the broader public, and the creators of this performance will actually get all the rights, because we wish that it continues to be shown. And at the end of this tour, we'll produce a short video film. So we wish to collect a lot of information and material, and a lot is already available, also through the partners' channels. And I invite you all to watch it, because it is really interesting.
Thank you, Matteja, for these very interesting examples, how you were making a circus around the climate change. And this is necessary if we want to alleviate the consequences of climate change.